Cebu City imposes mobility restrictions on residents who have not been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. Starting January 1st, unvaccinated individuals in the city are barred from entering local establishments. Unvaccinated minors aged 12 to 17 are also not allowed to enter any establishments, even if they are accompanied by fully vaccinated adults. The new policy is aimed at encouraging more people to get inoculated against the disease.
We are earnestly hoping that by January 1, dapat lahat na mababakunahan para lahat ay mabuksan.
The Philippines now at minimal risk for COVID-19. That's according to the Philippine Health Department, citing a national weekly positivity rate of 1.8%. It adds only three regions, Cagayan Valley, Mimaropa, and Zamboanga Peninsula, have a positivity rate of more than 5%, but are steadily declining. The national health system capacity also at low risk.
All regions show decrease in average daily attack rates compared to the previous 3 to 4 weeks and remain to be at minimal to low risk case classification with a negative 1 or 2 week growth rates. All regions have a total COVID-19 bed and ICU utilization at low risk or less than 50%. The National Capital Region is currently at low risk case classification.
The DOH, meanwhile, says 12 samples from returning overseas Filipinos are being sequenced for the Omicron variant. It assures the public measures are being taken to address its possible entry.
Ang pagpasok ng mga variants dito sa ating bansa, hindi yan, we cannot 100% control the prevent the entry of these variants. Ang ginagawa natin, we buy time when we prepare our system at gumawa tayo ng mga ganitong efforts sa ngayon, stricter border controls, biosurveillance, yung ating community response. This buys us time. Hindi natin sinasabi na it will not enter the country. Ang pinag-uusapan natin ngayon, when it will enter the country.
The Philippines is eyeing increasing its COVID-19 vaccination target to 90% due to the threat of the Omicron variant. But for data analysts, doing so would be a tall order since the country is already facing administration problems even with its initial target of vaccinating 70% or 54 million of its eligible population.
At our current pace, we would be able to reach 70% of the population by the first quarter of 2022, which is the target, also the revised target of the government right now. We have ample supply. As of latest data, we have 146 million total doses that have arrived in the country. But the problem really is the administration of vaccines, because if you have 146 million available, 146 million total, and you have just administered around 91 million total, then you have around 55 million doses available. So the challenge really is not the supply right now. We have more than enough supply.
The League of Provinces also points out the push for doubled vaccination efforts has not been easy. It says most provinces failed to reach the targets set by government for the national vaccination days due to a shortage in vaccinators. The country was able to administer 9.9 million doses following a two-day extension to the campaign, which ran from November 29th to December 3rd. The Philippines has arranged two repatriation flights for over 100 Filipinos stranded in Europe due to Omicron-induced travel restrictions. The Foreign Affairs Department says most of them will be coming from Italy and Turkey. The agency advises Filipinos abroad to coordinate with the Philippine Embassy for more details on the flights, which are scheduled on December 10th and 13th.
Kung mangyayari, we have to gather all the Filipinos all over Europe na talagang stranded to ride this plane. Tapos yung mga nakakaangat po sa buhay na kaya namang magbayad, pwede po sila magbayad. Pero yung mga talaga pong naubusan ng pera at talagang na-stranded, tutulong po yung pamahalaang Pilipinas para may uwi po sila.
The DFA also says they're still looking for a way to bring home Filipinos stuck in South Africa where the Omicron COVID variant was first detected. More than 2,000 elementary and senior high school students in Metro Manila returned to schools after nearly 2 years. 28 schools were selected across the capital region to join the pilot phase of in-person learning, which began in mid-November. The Education Department says necessary protocols are in place in case a student or personnel tests positive for the coronavirus.
Lahat ng mga eskwelahan ay dapat handa dito. At ang atin pong instruction ay kung meron na lalabas na kaso, whether whatever variant, ay istap po kaagad yung ating implementation.
Teachers and students who will participate in the face-to-face classes have already been tested and cleared from COVID-19. The Education Department sees further expansion in the pilot face-to-face classes by next month. That's amid good feedback so far. After more schools reopen today, the department will also submit a full report on the pilot run to President Duterte before the year ends.
And so far, it has been smooth. We have officials of the department that are on the ground at both the central office and the regions, Isakraki. And up to this time, I've been monitoring, and we have not received any adverse report. Since so far ay maganda ang tinatakbo, ay ang ating ina-anticipate ay ang magiging recommendation ay ang pagpapalawak nito at sa tinatawag naming expanded phase early next year.
A group of teachers calls on government to allocate more funds for the protection of teachers and students participating in face-to-face classes. Raymond Basilio of the Alliance of Concerned Teachers says students and teachers should be subjected to weekly antigen testing to prevent any outbreaks of the virus. He also urges government to ramp up vaccination of teachers, especially in the provinces.
In the provinces, the main reason why teachers are still not yet vaccinated is because of the supply of the vaccine. So many are still unvaccinated, not because of the hesitancy, but because of the supply. So I think that's around 10 to 20% of the teaching population who are yet to be vaccinated.